What's going on, Raider Nation? It's your boy, Sanji, and in this video, I want to discuss training camp with you guys because it is right around the corner. In fact, it's estimated that training camp will start in the next 2 weeks, and I am very excited because the Raiders roster is super deep this year, deeper than it's ever been over the last 3 to 5 years. I mean, you think about all the talent that's on the roster, from the cornerbacks, the 12 wide receivers on this roster, the 5 starting offensive linemen all coming back. This team is super, super deep. And if it could gel together, I really think that we have a shot to make the playoffs and possibly a Super Bowl run. But a lot of that will depend on how the team gels together. It is a first year team together in a lot of different phases, including the linebacker. The wide receivers are kind of new. The secondary is kind of new. The defensive line has some fresh talent as well. So it's going to be very exciting. But in this video, what I want to do is I want to share with you guys 3 training camp battles and potential cuts, and just discuss with you guys how difficult it's going to be to make some of these roster decisions because we're so freaking deep. And I want to start off right away getting into the cornerbacks, and then I want to talk a little bit about the tight ends, and finally I'm going to finish it up talking about the wide receivers group. I'm really excited, and the first thing I want to do is get right into the Raiders cornerbacks situation because it is super deep this year. This year, the Raiders have vets like Prince Amakamaru, LaMarcus Joyner, and Nevin Lawson, as well as rookies Damon Arnette, Amik Robertson, and Madre Harper. And then you consider the second-year players like Trayvon Mullen, Isaiah Johnson, Keyshawn Nixon, TJ Killings. The cornerback room is super deep. Out of those 10 corners, only 4 or 5 will actually make the roster. So let's discuss which players will make the roster, and let's discuss which players will start. Now, first and foremost, there's one player who is guaranteed to start and guaranteed to be on this roster, and that's second year standout corner Trayvon Mullen. Now, if you guys have not watched my film breakdown on Trayvon Mullen, go check it out because I broke down everything I love about the young kid. And in my opinion, I think he has a lot of good traits that can really make him a good solid corner and a starter for a number of years. Besides Trayvon Mullen, the other corners really aren't safe. So let's discuss which players will make this roster and let's discuss which players will end up starting. Now, there are 2 other players other than Mullen who will be on this roster solely because they were both drafted. And those are rookies Damon Arnette and Amik Robertson. Now, I'm really excited for both of these guys. And a lot of people think that Damon Arnette will probably start opposite of Trayvon Mullen. However, just like Trayvon Mullen last year did not start, I don't think Arnette is going to end up starting, which a lot of people might not agree with me. But I do predict that Arnette will not start right away. And in fact, I think a player like Prince Amakamaru makes a whole lot more sense to start. I mean, the guy is a 10-year veteran. He's played a number of years in the NFL. And in 2018, he started for the Chicago Bears defense that was #1 in the NFL, which means that if you have good players around Prince Amakamaru, he can be a starting piece for a good defense. And the Raiders really have started building a defense that, if it gels together, could be one of the best defenses in the NFL. And you think about every level of that defense, and there is nowhere that defense is really missing anything important. I mean, you look at the linebackers from Corey Littleton to Kwiatkowski. Tanner Mews could potentially be a star player as well, just like he was for Clemson while they're winning all those national championships. And then you look at the defensive line, and you have first round picks, second, third, fourth round picks all over that defensive line, including Max Crosby, who in my opinion is a very special talent. Then you look at that secondary, you look at all the young players, the first round picks, the second round picks, from Abram to Mullen to Arnette. The team is super stacked. It really just comes down to, are they gonna gel together? Getting back into the prediction of the cornerback position, I think Arnette will 100% make this roster. I think Amik Robertson and Trayvon Mullen will for sure make the roster. And outside of those guys, you kind of have to look at the contracts, right? If you consider those 3 guys making the roster, and let's just assume 3 other guys make the roster, you really have to look at the contract situation. LaMarcus Joyner is already under contract this year. If you cut LaMarcus Joyner, you lose $15 million. So in my opinion, there's no way the Raiders move on from LaMarcus Joyner. So now you have 4 corners on the active roster. The one prediction I will make with LaMarcus Joyner is I don't think he's going to end up starting. In fact, if I had to guess, Amik Robertson is going to take that role from LaMarcus Joyner. by week one of this season. Maybe not going into training camp and maybe not throughout preseason, but I think by week one, Amik Robertson will be the starter. And I know he's a rookie, but Robertson has a chip on his shoulder, and I love players to have chips on their shoulders. Then you look at other veterans on this team like Nevin Lawson and Prince Amakamaru. Now remember, Nevin Lawson was brought back in. He was actually a free agent and the Raiders decided to extend him. So now you think about it. Do you think the Raiders keep him going into the season? Especially when you consider we only have a limited number of players we can keep on the roster at that corner position. If I had to guess, I think Nevin Lawson is out. I think he'll end up getting cut by the last week of preseason cuts. I think the two biggest decisions that this team will have to make is going to be Isaiah Johnson and Keyshawn Nixon. Are we going to be able to keep both players? If not, will we move them to practice squad? I think there's a strong possibility both players will end up on the practice squad, especially if LaMarcus Joyner, Arnett, Robertson, and Prince Amakamaru make the active roster. That's already five players right there. We don't have a whole lot of roster positions for a possible fifth, sixth, or seventh cornerback spot, which means DJ Killings and Nevin Lawson are most likely gone, as well as rookie Madre Harper, who I think is a long shot at this point anyways, unless he really proves himself to be a potentially star-filled player. In that case, unless Isaiah Johnson and Keyshawn Nixon outperform him, those two guys could be gone as well. Remember, practice squad is also limited. You can't just sign every player to the practice squad. You're gonna have to really decide. Realistically, one or two corners at most will make the practice squad. Now, the one thing I do wanna consider is because of the pandemic and because of the NFL rules regarding players who get sick and how they can't practice until they test negative twice, as well as sitting out for 10 to 14 days, are they going to extend the roster spots? Are we going to go up from 53 to 57 to possibly like 70 players on the roster? I think it might make a whole lot more sense, at least from the practice squad perspective, to allow more roster spots. Now, moving forward into the second training camp battle, it's going to be very interesting to kind of see how the tight end battles kind of shape out. Currently, the Raiders have four tight ends on the roster. You have Darren Waller, Foster Moreau, Jason Witten, and Derek Carrier. Three of the four tight ends will make the roster, and two of the three that make the roster will have a lot of playing time. Now, we all know Foster Moreau tore his ACL last year, and because of that injury, is he going to be 100% healthy? Probably not. But when he is healthy, is he going to have more playing time than someone like Jason Witten? Because we all know that Darren Waller is going to be the guy going into this season. Now, let's compare some of their stats. Last year, Foster Moreau had 21 catches in 13 games for 174 yards, as well as 5 touchdowns. Now, in 3 more games, Jason Witten had 63 catches, 529 yards, and 4 touchdowns. Obviously, Jason Witten is a veteran, and he had a much better season last year than the rookie Moreau when it comes to catches and yards. Of course, Moreau also had less competition as opposed to Witten, had Michael Gallup and Amari Cooper to compete with, as well as Blake Jarwin, who is a pretty good tight end, and Ezekiel Elliott. But at the same time, Witten was a veteran, and you have a rookie in Moreau who's going to get a lot better this year. But if I had to guess, between Moreau, Witten, and Waller, who are the three tight ends I think that will make this roster, I believe that Waller and Witten will get majority of the snaps, and they will primarily be the ones out there on the field. Now, Witten's still a very good run blocker and pass blocker, so anytime we're going to take deep shots, I fully expect Witten to come into the game. Now, it's going to be interesting to kind of see how the tight end room shapes up, right? Witten's obviously the vet. He's obviously going to demand that respect and put that work ethic into some of the younger tight ends like Waller and Moreau. Of course, it'll be interesting to kind of see because Foster Moreau was still a pretty good tight end last year. You know, I still expect him to play when he does come back. It'll just be interesting to kind of see how much he plays. And that battle right there in training camp, in my opinion, is going to be very, very interesting. You know, I think about this all the time. The Raiders were on HBO last year on Hard Knocks, but really they should have been on Hard Knocks this year because this is the year that would have been, in my opinion, much more interesting. Now, moving forward into the third training camp battle, it's going to be very, very interesting how this one shapes up. And that's the Raiders wide receiving group. Now, right now we have 12 wide receivers on the roster, including Tyrell Williams, Henry Ruggs, Hunter Renfrow, Bryan Edwards, Anthony Williams, DeMornay Pearson-L, Siosa, Mariner, Zay Jones, Rico Gafford, Keelan Doss, Marcel Aitman, and Nelson Aguilar. 12 wide receivers. That's a shit ton of wide receivers. So it's going to be very interesting. Now, just in comparison, in 2018 and 2019, the Raiders kept 5 wide receivers on the active roster in each of those years. So out of the 12, 7 are going to most likely be cut. At max, we might end up keeping 6 wide receivers since we ended up drafting 2 of those wide receivers, which means those 2 guys are going to be on the roster. Although the rookies haven't signed, Bryan Edwards and Henry Ruggs are guaranteed roster spots because even though they have not signed their contract yet, they will still end up getting paid guaranteed money, which means they're going to be on the roster come week 1, which means that out of the other 10 wide receivers, with only 3 to 4 possible spots available, which other wide receivers can we guarantee to be on the roster? Hunter Renfrow is a very promising second year player. I don't see him going anywhere. In fact, if I had to predict this upcoming year, I think Hunter Renfrow might be the best wide receiver. As far as statistical, I think he's gonna have the best season. I think our wide receiving group is still really young, minus Tyrell Williams. And when it comes to young wide receivers, it typically takes anywhere from 6 to 7 games to really get on track, right? You look at Hunter Renfrow and all that damage he did in the last 4 to 5 weeks of the season, it really showed what he could do this year. And minus Hunter Renfrow, Bryan Edwards, and Henry Ruggs, there's not a whole lot of spots left, right? And Tyrell Williams, I think, is pretty much guaranteed a spot because of the fact that if you cut him, you owe him $11 million, and there's no way we're going to take a dead cap penalty of $11 million. It's just too much money to lose. And honestly, we really didn't get to see what Williams could do last year because he did have an injury. But when he didn't have an injury, he was a pretty good player in my opinion. Now, minus those 4 wide receivers, there are 2 or 3 other receivers that could possibly make the Raiders' final roster cut. Now, in my opinion, players like Keelan Doss, Zay Jones, Nelson Aguilar, and Rico Gafford have the best chances. The other players are just practice squad players, camp bodies, so I don't think those guys will end up making it. Pearson L was on the team last year. He ended up getting cut. I think the same fate is going to happen for him this year. Anthony Williams will not make the roster either. But if I had to predict among Rico Gafford, Keelan Doss, Zay Jones, and Nelson Aguilar, it's very hard because 1 or 2 of those guys will end up making the roster. I think Zay Jones will have a very, very high chance, as well as Nelson Aguilar. Both guys are veterans, and let's be honest, right? We don't want Derek Carr to have 2 rookies as his primary wide receivers because that's going to really push him back in the development of the offense. So if I had to really predict, I would say that minus the 4 that are already on the roster, Tyrell Williams, Hunter Renfrow, Henry Ruggs, and Bryan Edwards, I think the other 2 wide receivers to make this roster is going to end up being either Nelson Aguilar or Zay Jones. This depends on who does a better job during training camp. And I think the Raiders keep Rico Gafford. And I know that Rico Gafford is a player that a lot of people don't maybe know about, but one thing Rico Gafford has is he has speed. In fact, his speed can probably match Henry Ruggs' speed. The one thing is we don't know what his official 40 time was because he wasn't invited to the combine. And another thing is he was a cornerback in college. He was a cornerback in his first year in the NFL, and he only converted to a wide receiver this past season. And he had 2 long touchdowns for the Raiders. Unofficially, he ran a 4.23 40. Of course, that's unofficially, so we don't know if that's 100% true. But he was never actually fully tested, but he does have that speed, and I think the Raiders should keep him. I think it would be wise to keep someone like Rico Gafford because he does have that speed. Plus, he'd be the 6th wide receiver. The other 5 guys could be the possession, middle of the field, sidelines, good route runners, and Rico Gafford could just be that guy that goes deep. Mix that in with Henry Ruggs on the other side, it's going to be very hard for teams to not have safeties over the top, double teaming both of these guys, but then having to guard Darren Waller in the middle of the field. And if you do have 2 safeties deep, how are you going to stop Josh Jacobs? Think about that. You can't stop Josh Jacobs with 7 guys in the box. You have to bring that 8th guy down, which is one of those safeties. And if you have to guard Henry Ruggs, Rico Gafford, maybe even Bryan Edwards or Tyrell Williams deep or down the field, it's going to be very, very hard to stop this offense. When you look at it from the offensive line perspective, the potential talent in the wide receiving group, the quarterback, the running backs, you look at that defense. The Raiders have a real shot this year to make a Super Bowl run. The team just has to gel together. And I want to know what you guys think. Make sure to hit that thumbs up button. If you enjoyed this video, hit that subscribe button. And I'll see you guys next time with another video.